You're listening to Kpoppin, every day 12 to 2 p.m. The fastest K-pop news with DJ Isak.
Ugly Truth. It's time to lay it down thick with the ugly truth with Sooyoon of Royal Pirates in the
Hello.
Studio. Hello. How are you?
I'm good.
I hear that you've been pretty busy these days. RP's been doing a lot of tours and overseas promotions.
Right. And we wanted to go to Singapore, actually. We had a show. We were supposed to do a show in Singapore, but we were supposed to go to Singapore with Minho. For his fan-meeting concert, but it got canceled.
So
we couldn't go to Singapore. But then our fans, who were supposed to come to our fan-meeting show, they actually gathered together and they just had like their own greeting, like own meeting. I really felt bad for not being able to join.
Oh no!
Yeah. So sorry if our fans in Singapore, we really wanted to go. But we'll go soon. We'll get another chance.
I'm not saying that other teams don't, but when it comes to RP and they say that they really want to go somewhere, they really want to go.
Yeah, right.
They really want to go. They really want to go.
And also, I really wanted to go because it's so cold here, but in Singapore, it's
so
really
warm.
Yeah.
Oh, Sooyoon not liking the cold weather.
Right.
I have a feeling that for the next couple of months, you're going to be like, it's so cold. But for me, it's like, it's cold. I love it when it's cold.
Because you like making the sweaters and hats.
No, not because of that. I have really, really high blood temperature.
Ah.
So I'm a little bit hotter than most people.
Mm.
So I'm very, very, very warm-blooded.
Awesome.
So in winter, I am very, very, very warm.
Mm.
So my hands are always warm in the wintertime. So I tend to be a little bit warmer. So I like it when it's cold outside.
Cool.
Love it. I hate hot. I hate being hot.
Mm.
I hate it. Okay. Anyways, we're not going to be talking about me hating heat today. We're going to be talking about some of our listener stories.
Uh-huh.
We've got some pretty long and interesting stories for this week. So I'm loving it because our listeners are giving us a lot of detail.
Right.
So let's look at our first story.
Okay. It's from the Philippines, from Isabel. Hello, DJ Isak and Sooyoon. Hope you could give me some advice and help me with a problem. I have a guy friend. He just had his girlfriend, first girlfriend, earlier this year. It was okay at the first few months of their relationship, but things got bad when he found out that the girl was flirting around with a lot of guys behind his back. Whenever he confronts the girl, she'll just say, "Oh, he's just a friend. Don't worry about it." But he still felt that he was cheated on. That's why he started to flirt, and he started to go out on dates with other girls. There was a time when I asked if he'll ever stop on playing around. He just said, "I'll stop when the day comes and when she stops flirting with other people and just focuses on me and our relationship." Most of his friends also kept on telling him to break it off with his girlfriend, but he just keeps on saying, "I don't want to. I still love her. She's my first love." On my mind, that reasoning is just downright stupid. Why stick to a relationship that doesn't make you happy? But I'll never know how much a person's stupidity could go once they start loving someone. I haven't been in a romantic relationship. That's why I decided to share this and ask help from you guys. P.S. It's just sad seeing a good and once a faithful guy to be like this just because his girlfriend is playing around. I guess Sooyoon can help a lot since he's a guy and his point of view is important in this problem.
Okay. Okay, so it's Team A or Team B. Mm-hmm. Just tell your guy friend to not do this again. That's Team A. B, the memories of first love will last long. Try to support him as a friend.
All right.
Boy's perspective.
Yeah.
Let's get Sio's POV here.
All right. I think, yeah, just like Isabel said that I think it's pretty stupid to just go flirting with other girls and have going on dates with other girls just because his girlfriend is doing that.
I know that I might get criticized for saying this, mm-hmm. but I do not understand open relationships.
Yeah.
I feel that the mm-hmm. phrase of open relationship means I can do whatever I want with somebody else, but technically I'm still your girlfriend.
Right.
So, I don't understand this.
Yeah, it's like you just have the title
yeah.
of being a girlfriend, but you know, you can do whatever you want and I can do whatever I want.
Which completely defeats the purpose
right.
the actual title itself.
Right, right.
Like marriage. We're in an open marriage. I don't understand this phrase because what? You're just going to... Okay, Soon and I are married, but I can do whatever I want with anybody else.
Yeah.
But no. We still have that title.
Yeah.
Now, if you're doing that for just strictly legal reasons, I think that it's even the more so. Stop doing it.
Yeah.
But I don't understand this. This is... You're not in the relationship with her anymore.
Yeah.
I agree with Isabel. He's not in love with her anymore, I don't think.
I feel like he's still in love with her, but I feel like that girl's not in love with him. So I think since it's his first girlfriend, I feel like he probably like poured all out his heart to her. And I feel like this girl is probably not, you know, first love. And this girl's probably had a lot of relationships in the past. And she just kind of, you know, for her, his just one of those many guys, I feel like. So she's just kind of playing around. And I feel like the guy, your friend, is kind of, he wants to be loyal to her. But since she's doing that, he can't, like, he's just trying to release that stress and release kind of like, okay, he's just trying to be cool. She's just trying to play cool, but he's not actually cool, I feel like. Inside, he's probably hurt. And inside, he still probably loves her the most. He's just flirting and playing around just to kind of get her attention, I feel like.
Ah.
And, yeah. I feel like I've been through something like this.
Oh,
before.
No! I think we should upgrade Team A. Team A, let's try and have Isabel try to convince him to break up with her.
Right.
I think Team A should be try to convince him to break up with her. So the advise him to sternly not do this again is to break up with her.
Yeah.
Team B is try to understand him as a friend. So let's change it that way.
Okay.
I'd go with Team A.
Yeah. I'll go with Team A too.
So this similar situation, what is this going on? What? What?
Right.
I'm not going to pass this on. So what? You had a very similar situation. When? Huh? What? What?
I think my first girlfriend as well.
Ah.
Yeah. She was much more experienced than I was. And my first love was like, I was so into her. But for her, I was just like one of those... Just one of the many boyfriends she had. So it was just that she was just kind of cool. She wanted more space and like free time for herself and whatnot. And she wanted to have like just guy friends. And she wanted to hang out with other people.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, it's just like just her.
Mm-mm-mm.
So I felt I could kind of, now I could kind of understand why she did that, because maybe for her, I was kind of too clingy. And for her, maybe... but then, I feel like... she probably felt like, oh, Sooyoon doesn't know anything. So I could kind of, you know, get away with things. And so I think she did that more. Like, just what she said here. Oh, he's just a friend. Don't worry about it. I think it was easier for her to do that because I wasn't experienced. And I was like, oh, I guess... Okay, but inside I'm still skeptical, you know? And so I think the same thing happening here. And he can't break up with her because It's his first love, and he has so much expectations about this love, whole love thing, and he just wants to keep going on. He wants to work it out, but it's just not gonna work, and he has to accept it, I
Okay.
think. Yeah.
Okay. So it's team A or team B. Obviously tell him not to do this anymore and to pretty much give up on the relationship. Trying to help the current guy in question
Right.
realize that he needs to break up with a girl.
Yeah.
Or B, have Isabella just respect his memory of the first love and this whole idea of
Right.
how beautiful the first love has to be and just let him be.
Mm.
I'm gonna try and go with Team A, even though I don't normally go for trying to break up somebody
Mm,
on
right.
purpose.
Yeah.
But what do you think? Team A? Team B?
Yeah, I think I'll go Team A.
Okay.
Just tell him all the reasons why he has to break up with her. I'm pretty sure it's not gonna work
It's not
because
gonna work.
he doesn't know yet,
He's not
but
gonna realize it.
right.
But
But still.
I mean, Isabel, I think that you as a friend, that's as far as you can go.
Yeah.
Unless you actually catch her in the act,
Yeah.
like cheaters, like the show Cheaters, where they like hunt them down and like stalk them and like take videos and pictures of them
I mean,
like meeting up with them.
even I feel like even if he found out, he would still be like, I could forgive her. You know? I hope that doesn't happen, but yeah.
I understand though. I mean, once you're full in love. Once you're
Right.
head over heels, you're head over heels.
Right.
But maybe showing him other relationships, not necessarily showing him other girls, because it's not going to help him right now. No girl is better than his current girlfriend, I
Yeah.
feel. But maybe showing him different relationships. Maybe if you guys have older friends or friends at church or friends on your block or in your neighborhood that are maybe married or a little bit more mature.
Yeah.
What I mean is like older couples that are more mature. Maybe have a few dinners with your friend and you,
Yeah.
and have him kind of realize what a actual happy, functional relationship looks like, and then have him kind of realize through that, meeting
Right.
those older couples, that oh, that is what respect looks like. That
Yeah.
is what a guy should be doing for a girl. That is what the girl in the relationship should be doing for the guy.
Right.
Or if you have partners, what a partner should be doing in that relationship and staying instead of taking it for granted, like Sooyoon has had in the past as well.
All right.
Man, oh, those girls, I swear. I'm trying to think, have I ever done this? I'm trying to think if I've ever done this. Me? Okay, I
Maybe
don't like this.
unintentionally.
I think I did it
And
unintentionally. It was kind of
Yeah.
a
I think I
wake
did.
up call. Like, what ended up happening was the guy in the relationship kind of mustered up the courage to tell me, I don't like this. And it was kind of a wake up call, like, oh, wait, what? Oh, that's offensive. Oh, that's
Right.
offensive.
I think it happens a lot when one person is more experienced and then one person's less experienced.
Or if somebody likes you more.
Yeah,
If
yeah.
someone likes you more in the relationship. So if, let's say, I liked Soyun
Yeah.
before we started dating, and then Soyun got the courage, or like I was crushing on him, and then we started dating.
Yeah.
Obviously, I'm going to be putting more into the relationship than
Yeah,
Soyun is.
yeah,
So in the first couple of months, there's going to be more of me like,
yeah,
who is that?
yeah, yeah.
Who's that person that just put like on your status? Who's this? Who's so and so?
Yeah. You
How do you
know,
know her?
Facebook, I feel like Facebook and Twitter just and all that, you know,
Ruin
yeah,
relationships.
they ruin relationships
They do. Do not look at somebody's like history. All right, so for our listeners, what should Isabel do? This guy is head over heels over his first girlfriend. She's obviously not in this relationship 100%.
Yeah.
He's doing exactly what she's doing, but I feel it's hurting the relationship, and so does Isabel. So, should she A, try to convince him to break up with her, and obviously not to do this again, or B, to just kind of have Isabel let him walk into his own pit of fire?
Yeah.
Just let him be, just, respect him in a friendship. What should they do? Team A or Team B? Tell us what they should be doing. We're going to take a listen to Ali's track of Sangcho, Scars, and we'll see you after this with our next story.
See ya.
So we're continuing to ask for A or B for Isabel from the Philippines. We'll recap for the story for you in just a bit. Next story, very short, kind of like last week. Our second story was pretty short last week too, but powerful. So we have an anonymous listener.
Right, it's from Singapore. Dear Isaac and Soon, what would you do if you found out your ex and best friend are in a relationship for some time now, and they kept it a secret from you? Should you still be friends with your exes? I'm just wondering.
Wait, so it's not your current boyfriend, but your ex and your best friend.
Right.
No. No. No.
Nope.
No.
Yeah.
Awkward.
Yeah.
He has got your leftovers. Ew. We talked about this last week. Thanks to Snow.
Oh, gosh. I mean, I don't know why this happens so often. But it happens so much around us. I mean, around me.
Yeah, you said that.
Yeah. I think especially when I was back in LA, where the Korean society was so small, and everybody was just like meeting everybody else. And I even had did I say this before? But I had one of my best friends dated this girl for like, I think like 1 or 2 years. And then after like 5 years passed.
Ah.
So my best friend dated this girl when he was like in high school or beginning of college.
Okay.
And then he broke up. And after like 5 years, his cousin, which is like one of his best friend, is like, okay, so his name is Teddy. And okay, Teddy, can I date this girl, which was your ex-girlfriend? You know? And Teddy's just like,
what? 5 years has passed. I think it'll be less awkward.
Yeah, but
less awkward.
Still,
yeah, but still awkward.
Yeah, but then at least this cousin didn't keep it a secret.
True.
Yeah,
he was honest about it.
Yeah, that's very important. I feel
very important.
So Teddy was like, at least he was honest and at least he's truthful to he actually likes the girl.
Mm-mm-mm.
So it's not like he's just trying to play around.
Mm-mm-mm.
So okay, if it's, you know, if you really like her, then okay, go for it. So
okay.
They were cool about it
because
they're honest.
Okay,
but I feel like if he kept it a secret and Teddy found out later,
that
would have been really heartbreaking for Teddy, and I feel like Teddy would have been really hurt.
Mm.
Yeah,
it's so true. So in this situation, obviously the honesty here is the biggest factor, not just the fact that your ex and your best friend are dating.
Yeah.
But I've said this before. I don't see how people can do this.
Mm.
I know that if we watch Friends or Sex in the City or even if we watch like Big Bang Theory and stuff like that. I mean, there's very random, like people end up dating people's friends.
Yeah.
Especially when we think of Friends, the sitcom.
Yeah.
Everybody dated everybody, I think, once. Except Rachel and Ross because they were brother and sister. But it's, I feel that it's going to be awkward either way.
Yeah.
Because for the best friend, and I'm taking this from a girl's perspective.
Yeah.
If my best friend ended up dating my ex.
Yeah.
I would think that number one, she wasn't a true friend to me. Because whether I liked him or didn't like him, or I was the reason why we broke up.
Uh-huh.
She knows all my deep, dark secrets because it's not just my friend. This is my best friend we're talking about here. So she knows all my deep, dark secrets.
Yeah.
And then I wouldn't necessarily blame my ex for going out with my best friend.
Mm-hmm.
I would end up blaming my best friend for actually going out with my ex, knowing all the weight of the relationship that we had before.
Yeah.
So it wouldn't be going for, and even if it was, you know, either way around, I feel that it's just,
and especially when it's not just, you know, any of your friends, but if it's your best friend, for example, if it was like James, for me, if James dated my ex, or if I dated James's ex, you know, if I were to date one of James's ex, and we hang out, and then, you know, like, when you're serious in your relationship, you have to kind of like meet your friends with your girlfriend.
Exactly.
Yeah, and then
it's awkward.
You can't hang out. I can't ever hang out with James. You know
exactly.
What I mean? And it just kind of becomes hard to do anything after a while
because
you like to hang out. I have to hang out with James sometimes, and then my ex would be uncomfortable.
Exactly.
Or my current girlfriend would be uncomfortable.
Because she dated
Yeah, and James would be uncomfortable, like, obviously.
Exactly.
And it's just like, it's just not,
It's not worth
it's
it.
not cool. Yeah, it's not worth it.
It's not worth
There's
it.
so many other people, like,
Yeah.
out there.
Now I've had this happen before. So, a previous boyfriend of mine. Now this is going to be like he said, she said. So take t so listen carefully. It's not a listening exam, but listen carefully.
right.
So let's say I have a friend called Anne.
Okay.
Okay. Now Anne, obviously, we got to know each other in our 20s.
Is this real name?
No.
Okay.
So Anne. I got to know her in my 20s, so I don't know her high school friends, her junior high
I
friends,
see.
her elementary friends. I don't know them.
Okay.
I just got to know her in my 20s. We are pretty much best friends.
Okay.
Now, she had a group of friends, which were her high school, junior high, you know, she grew up together type of friends.
Yeah.
And she had a birthday party,
Yeah.
and when I was dating someone else, I went to that birthday party and I met her girlfriends. So
Okay.
her non-my friend, circle of friends, friends. So like junior high, all those friends. I'm not really good with people,
Yeah.
so I'm really bad with names.
Yeah,
I'm really bad with all this other stuff.
yeah.
So Anne's group of girls,
Yeah.
one of her friends, let's just call her Beth. Oh, I'm going alphabetical order here.
Oh,
Anyways,
I see.
so I met Beth at the party. Don't really remember much of her, honestly. It was just we had a lot of drinks, so yeah. And I didn't really pay attention because I went with a date that night. I had a boyfriend at the time. Beth was complaining that she had this really bad boyfriend. He was, oh, whatever, whatever, whatever. She was in the process of breaking up with him. He's a jerk. He's whatever. I was like, oh, man, you know, break up with him. Oh, you deserve better. We took like a group picture, posted it up on, you know, like SNS and whatever. That was that. I never saw her after that party. 3 years later, I started dating this guy, and totally did not know that he would have any connection to these people. He was like, "So, when have you and Anne be friends?" And I was just like, "Anne? My Anne? How do you know her?" He's like, "She's my ex's best friend." And so I was just like, "Who's your ex?" It's like, "You know who my ex is." I'm just like, "I do?" And I was like, okay, hold up. I don't think I need to start this relationship. I think I need to stop everything in this relationship right now before it gets weird. Apparently, that Beth that I just met once didn't really remember. He broke up with her around that time and was single for the next 3 years.
I see.
And then
Met you.
it met me.
Yeah.
We ended up dating,
Yeah.
but it was very awkward because I ended up meeting up with Anne
Yeah.
and she knows what happened with Beth.
Yeah.
And so it was very awkward for her and for him because even though I didn't know Beth directly, I only saw her once, it was still a very awkward situation.
I see,
So every time I complained about my then boyfriend doing something, she was just like, and she would bite her tongue, and I'm just like, what? What? She's like, I heard the same thing from Beth.
Oh, gosh.
I'm just like, I think I need to have a talk with Beth.
Yeah.
But what annoyed me was that while I was dating that particular guy, Beth would contact him every once in a while. And he still had like what we had in Isabel's story in the beginning. It was kind of his first love.
Oh, I
So
see.
whenever she wrote him or talked to him or called him,
He couldn't stop.
he couldn't stop.
Yeah.
And that pissed me off.
Yeah.
That pissed me off. I was really annoyed.
Right.
And it didn't stop for the entire relationship that we had. And I
Wow.
dated him for about 3 years.
Wow.
So, I know the power of the first love thing. So if we
Yeah.
go back to the first story,
Right.
but in this situation, this was like a friend of a friend and it was still awkward. So for our remaining anonymous listeners, Singapore
Yeah.
ex and best friend, how more awkward do you think this is going to be? It's
Yeah.
going to be even more awkward. Mine was awkward.
Yeah.
How do you think yours is going to be?
Right.
Everything is awkward. But I do want to say, if our anonymous listener, if your ex and your best friend, if one of the two listens to K-Poppin, word of the wise, it's not worth it
Yeah, it's
for
not
you
worth it.
two.
Right.
It's not worth it. I don't care how madly in love with you guys are,
Yeah.
it's not worth it.
It's not gonna last long.
It's not.
Yeah.
I know that they say that, you know, your friends do change over a span of about 7 years, but still, it's not just a friend. It's even not even a friend of a friend. It's your best friend and your ex. That's treason on so many levels. That's like them. That's like cheating on.
Treason.
Because then, I mean, even for me naturally,
Yeah.
I would end up wondering, Did my best friend lie to me while I was dating my ex?
Mm-hmm.
What, did they secretly have a crush on my ex? Or
were
they fooling around behind my back while we were dating?
Yeah.
That's a question that pops up immediately. Mm-hmm. And then the trust factor for your best friend and your ex goes down the drain.
Yeah. Especially when they kept it a secret from you.
Exactly.
Yeah. And you ask, should you still be friends with your exes?
No.
No. No, no friends with exes.
No friends with exes. Soyoon and I have talked about this. Like, if you have to stay coworkers for unfortunate reasons, staying professional and staying friends is completely different.
Yeah.
I could stay professional. Mm-hmm. If Soyoon and I dated, I could stay professional.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I would act like, you know, nothing happened.
Yeah.
But that would be it. I wouldn't contact him afterwards. And then if like our company was having a, you know, an after party at radio, I wouldn't call him if we dated and we broke up.
Mm-hmm.
That would be very awkward.
Yeah.
So you can stay professional with your exes, but you cannot stay friends.
Yeah. No friends.
No friends. That is no bueno.
Yeah.
No bueno, no bueno. All right. Going back to our first story about the first love.
Mm-hmm.
Isabel's favorite guy friend is kind of become a playboy because his current girlfriend.
Mm.
So she started it. Now he's doing it just to piss her off.
Mm.
So what should Isabel try to do? Convince him to break up with her, which both Soyoon and I think should be done.
Mm-hmm.
And or B, to just respect him as a guy, give him space and wait till he realizes how much of an idiot he is. That is so A or B, what do you think? Start sending in your votes if you haven't already. One lucky winning team member is going to get Polaroids of Soyoon.
Yay.
We have more music for our listeners before we jump back into our next story. UKISS is singing Chingue Sarang, Friends Love.
All right.
So we're moving on to our last story for today for our ugly truth, and it's from Bangladesh.
Mm-hmm. It's from In.
Okay.
Yin. Hello. Well, I was a good student and my marks were very satisfying. But for the last 1 year, I can't concentrate on my study anymore. My marks are getting lower and lower. My parents are really hurt. I feel like crying when I see my parents' faces. Even my friends are also angry with me. I'm always with my phone, PC, internet, TV, especially K-pop. I realize this, but I can't control myself. I really want to be that old me.
That's it? That's it? That's it?
That's it.
Yeah. Welcome to the real world. Welcome to the real world.
Mm.
That is just a tip of the iceberg of what the real world does to you. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Am I the only one that thinks this?
I can't, you know, I can't ever, ever practice like I used to when I was in junior high.
I can't either.
Yeah, I can't ever read a book like that. I can't ever practice drums like that. I can't, I'm like so lazy compared to like who I was before.
I think it's not just the lazy part, but for you, I mean, drums.
Yeah.
When you first started playing the drums, I'm guessing that it was a hobby at first.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now it's a job.
Yeah, it's a job now.
That's why I'm guessing that the it's not so much laziness.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just become a necessity
that
you just don't tend to go to more.
And then there's so many like
there's temptations.
There's temptations all around you, you know?
Everywhere you
like,
go.
Let's hang out here, you know?
Soyoon, let's go drink!
Yeah, right? Seriously, you know? And there's so much temptations, and like if I want to watch a movie, let's say before in high school, you know, I have to kind of like make that money, get that ride from my mom, you know. But now I can just kind of go if I want to. I have that money, I have the ride, you know, I just go if I want to. And I have so much time to spend for myself, like doing stuff I want to do, you know. If I want to, for example, listen to music, before I have to kind of like burn CDs and you know, like listen to like find all the music stations, blah blah blah. Now I just like go buy a music on iTunes and I just listen to it. It's so easy to access all the all the good temptations out there, you know. Trying to I guess I guess not necessarily wasting your time, but kind of, you know, taking your focus. Yeah.
And as you get older, it's going to get worse.
Yeah.
Like Sooyoon was saying, he made a really good point. There's more you time.
Yeah.
You're less institutionalized, right, I'd like to
right,
say.
Right.
If you guys are big Shawshank Redemption fans, if you've seen the movie Shawshank Redemption, a inmate that was there for most of his life gets released on good behavior when he's like in his 70s, 80s. And since he's been there for so long, he doesn't know cars because it was, you know, obviously the beginning of, you know, when cars became popular.
Yeah.
So a lot of things have changed, and he just felt that he was not fitting in well. And so he was, you know, institutionalized. He was so used to being behind bars, being fed, eating at a certain time. It's kind of like being at school.
Yeah.
It's like you're in school, you go to school at a certain time, get your grades, do this, do that, do that, do that.
Yeah.
As you get older, you realize that you're not going to die if you don't live by those standards.
Yeah.
And it becomes easier and easier to be like, I'll just watch this one TV show and then I'll get back to study.
Yeah.
So, no, I'll listen to this one song and then I'll get back to study.
Right.
This one paper's not going to kill my grade.
Yeah.
I'm not going to do this paper.
Yeah, yeah.
You find out that those responsibilities do come, but also the weight of getting punished gets lifted off of you.
Yeah.
When you were little, when your mom started yelling at you, you're like, it's the end of the world. I'm going to die. Mom's going to kill me. But as you get older, you know that she's not going to kill you.
Yeah.
So the burden of actually getting your stuff done lessens.
Yeah.
And so that welcome to life.
Yeah.
I'm like this though as well. For our listener, I work very well in a schedule that I don't make.
I see.
So if somebody's like, okay, you need to wake up at 6 a.m., you need to eat at this time, you need to do this, you need to do that. I'm very good at following orders, but when I have to make my own, I'm just like, nah, I'll do tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah.
And because I know that it's not going to kill me if I don't do it.
Yeah.
If I don't go to the gym today, it's not going to kill me.
Yeah.
Am I going to gain like 20 pounds overnight? No.
Yeah.
But this building up is going to be 20 pounds maybe a year from now. So you learn that the world is not going to die, or you're not going to die if you don't do something. And I feel that that weight being lifted causes temptations.
Right. So I think what's important is to find out why you want to do this stuff. Yeah. You have to find the reason, not because you shouldn't do stuff because your parents want you to do it and because you don't want to disappoint your parents and your friends. I think you should work on your stuff because you want to work on those stuff. And I think it's really important that you find the reason why you want to work on those stuff. For example, I practice drums and I practice guitar and, you know, writing songs because I had a purpose to become like a great musician. And I didn't do those things because my parents told me, obviously, yeah. And I even disappointed my parents by doing music, but I still wanted to do music because I wanted to, and it was easier for me to resist all the temptations. And all my friends, like, went out to 노래방, you know, and, you know, when they were in high school and they just, you know, went to mall and watched a movie, but I was in my home just, like, practicing my drums, you know, banging on my drums like by myself, which was like really ironic because it was easier for me to do that than go play.
Okay.
Because I had a like clear purpose
of and a passion
that
you wanted
passion.
To do.
Yeah.
So Yin, I mean, obviously you're upset that you are not as good of a student that you were, but obviously you have been seeing other you're not subconsciously. You know that you don't want to be that student anymore, I think. I feel that there's something else that you are striving for.
Yeah.
Find what you're striving for first and then start striving for it so that at least you know the reason why your grades are falling. So obviously for Sooyoon, he sacrificed going out and being reckless with his friends to start a passion that has led him to this day.
Yeah.
So for you, this could help you in the future as well. So hopefully that'll help. Jumping back to our first story for Isabel.
Yeah.
Because we are slightly running out of time, we're going to choose the winner after the show. So you can continue to send in what Isabella should do for her best guy friend. Mm. He's in a really bad relationship right now. The girl is not in the relationship at all, flirting, kind of being a playgirl. So now he's doing it.
Yeah.
It's like eye for an eye.
Yeah.
And this is not a relationship in Isabel's eyes. So what should she do? We both advise that she should A, really convince him to break up with this girl. Or B, maybe Isabel should just be a really loyal friend and let him be.
Right.
Let him be. We're going to find out who takes the win after this, but we're going to be posting that on our message board because Sooyoon and I have to go. Oh, it's so sad. we've got Standing Egg with Rest or Hyushik. And we're going to see you next week.
See you guys. Bye.
Bye.